Tell me.
At
topmost point I am asking, which direction it will be? Can acceleration be in the direction of velocity? Can it be in the direction of velocity? Yes or no?
Yes.
Achha. If it is in the direction of velocity, will it change its magnitude or not?
Yes.
It will change its magnitude. Yes or no? If, right now, if acceleration is in the direction of velocity, it will change the magnitude of the velocity. Something which we have done in motion 1D. Yes or no? If acceleration is in the direction of velocity, it will change the magnitude of the velocity. So acceleration will be, write down, acceleration in uniform circular motion direction will be always perpendicular to the velocity. Write down. See, if acceleration is in the direction of velocity, it will change its magnitude. And we are trying to find out situation for uniform circular motion. Magnitude is constant, right? So the acceleration has to be perpendicular to the velocity. Understood? Any doubt here? Okay. So perpendicular directions, two directions are there, upwards and downwards. Which direction it will be? Towards the center or away from the center?
Towards the center.
Towards the center. You are pulling it always towards the center so that it becomes a circular motion. What will happen if you don't pull it? It just fly away like that. It will just fly away. So you have to pull it towards the center so that it turns this way. And then you keep on pulling it towards the center. Then only it will make a circular motion. Otherwise, if you stop applying force, the particle will go tangentially. Do you understand this thing? Suppose you are tying a string with a stone and you rotate like this and the string breaks. The stone will just fly away tangentially or not? And it will hit someone if somebody is there. So the thing is that why you need string? Why do you think you need a string? To apply a force to have the acceleration which is required to move in a circle. Are you getting it? All of you please listen again. Why you need a string when you are rotating a stone in a circle? To apply force on the stone. To apply force on the stone. So that it creates the acceleration which is required to change the direction of velocity. Getting it? Getting it? Now tell me other examples of circular motion. Any example? No, give me a day-to-day life example of a very, very common example.
Frisbee
moves also, no? It moves also. Tell me an example.
Microwave.
You know Earth. Earth is revolving around the sun. Almost circular path. There has to be a force or not? Is there a force? There is a gravitational force. If gravitational force is not there, what will happen to Earth? Earth will go tangentially into the space. Into the space. And after 5-6 hours, the temperature of the Earth will drop to 3 or 4 Kelvin, which is like minus 200 degrees Celsius. And all of, and everyone will be dead. You know that the average temperature of the universe is how much, you know that? 3 Kelvin. 3 Kelvin is minus 270 degrees Celsius. So we are living at an extremely hot place of the universe. Huh? Yeah, 0 Kelvin is minus 273 degrees Celsius. So 3 Kelvin is minus 270 degrees Celsius. Okay? So, give me another example you can think of. Any other example? Jogging in a circular path. Okay, fine, but then this is a friction that it gives you.
Oh,
Okay, if car takes a sharp turn, it is difficult or not? Graduate turn is easier. So if you are suddenly changing the velocity, you need more force. Suddenly changing direction, you need more force. So maybe friction is not sufficient to create that much force. So if car will skid. Or you are riding a bicycle. Suppose you don't have so much money to ride bicycle instead of car. So if you take a sharp turn, you will slide. So you take a graduate turn. Okay. Another example is, do you know there is something called atom? Yes. Electron revolves around the atom. You know this or not?
Yeah.
How many of you know there is something called atom and electron? Okay, good. So you are educated. You don't know. So when electron is moving in a circle, so it needs a force to create the attraction towards the center. What is that force?
Not nuclear force.
There is an electric force, electrostatic force. Positive charge gets attracted towards the negative charge. Understood? So every time there is a circle motion, there must be a force towards this center. Otherwise, circular motion, even if it is uniform, is not possible. Understood? Okay? But the kind of numericals will be asked will be very straightforward. They will be asking you, find the time it takes to complete one revolution. Or suppose I ask you, write down a numerical, please. Write down. Just one final numerical, then we take a test. The numerical is this, that an object is moving with constant speed of 10 by pi meter per second about a circle of radius 10 meters. Understood the question? 1 dividing by pi, so that when you multiply 2 pi, pi get cancelled out. Okay? You need to find time. How much time will it take so that the angle of revolution is 120 degree? You understood this? If it takes full circle, the angle is 360. This much is 180. This much is 180. This much is again 180. Do you know this or not? Okay. No, actually I teach 11th and 12th, so at times I don't know how much is already taught to you until 8th. Anyways, find out the time it will take to complete 120 degrees. Please do it quietly and raise your hands if you have done. Okay, how many of you got the answer already? Okay, so keep quiet then. Keep quiet. Close the door. Oh, it doesn't get cancelled. Sorry. Sorry about it. Guys, take it as 10 pi. See, I want pi to get cancelled. till here. This is 120 degrees. Understood? So you can see that entire circle you can divide into three parts of 120. Okay? So if total length of the circle is 2 pi r, this 120 degree segment will have a length of 2 pi r divided by 3. Right? So you got the distance traveled is 2 pi r divided by 3 and speed is 10 meter per second. Come here. 10 pi meter per second. Right? So 2 pi r divided by 3 divided by the speed. Okay? Now r is how much? R is 10. 2 pi r divided by 3 divided by 10 pi. So 10 pi goes away, you get 2 by 3 seconds. Understood? 4. We'll meet at 11 after 10 minutes. Or no, okay, fine, 15 minutes. 11:20, okay? 11:20 the test starts. Those whoever comes here, for them the test starts. And the test will end at 12:20 sharp. It doesn't matter what time you come here.